Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Smita, pediatric ophthalmology and strabismus consultant at Vision Eye Centers, New Delhi. I completed my two-year fellowship at Shankara Eye Hospital, Coimbatore in 2017. Today, I will be talking about inferior oblique weakening procedures in intermittent divergent squint. Intermittent exotropia is the most common type of exotropia and is frequently encountered in clinical practice. It starts as a latent deviation, shifts to an intermittent exotropia, and then becomes constant. Binocularity is present in the phoric phase, but with progression, one eye becomes suppressed. Horizontal deviations are commonly associated with A and V patterns. In V pattern exotropia, the divergence is more in up gaze and less in down gaze. This is because of inferior oblique overaction. V pattern is considered to be significant if there is a difference of 15 prism diopters between up gaze and down gaze measurements. The inferior oblique overaction manifests as over elevation of the eye in adduction and is seen in 70% of the patients with exotropia. The amount of inferior oblique overaction is defined as the angle formed by the intersection between a horizontal line and the tangent line, which corresponds to the direction of ocular movement. Various surgical procedures have been described to weaken the inferior oblique, and these include recession, tenotomy, myotomy, myectomy, denervation extirpation, anterotranspositioning, anteronasal transpositioning, and graded anterotranspositioning. Grade 1 does not require any weakening procedure. Grade 2 and 3 can be corrected by recession, while grade 4 requires anterotranspositioning. And if severe extortion is present, then anteronasal transpositioning is the procedure of choice. However, the inferior oblique recession is preferred to disinsertion, myectomy, and myotomy by many surgeons because of the ability to achieve a graded response and the lower risk of unpredictable reattachment of the inferior oblique muscle to the sclera. Here, I will be demonstrating the technique that I learned during my fellowship at Shankara Eye Hospital, Coimbatore. Fornix incision is made 8 mm from the limbus in the inferotemporal quadrant, in the conjunctiva and the Tenens capsule. The inferior oblique muscle is identified and then hooked. It is not advisable to hook the muscle blindly. The muscle is clamped near the lateral rectus border and then disinserted from the globe. Six-zero polyglactin sutures are applied at the stump. The inferior rectus is then hooked and the inferior oblique is reattached to the sclera according to the amount of recession that is needed. Here it is being attached at 3 mm posterior and 2 mm lateral to the lateral border of the inferior rectus. This is known as Park's point. The conjunctiva is then closed with 80 polyglactin sutures or with glue. Inferior oblique weakening procedures do not affect the horizontal deviation. and give good results post-operatively. This procedure reduces the inferior oblique overaction and collapses the V pattern. This technique can be combined with bilateral lateral rectus recession, unilateral recess resect procedures, and bimedial resections. In the end, I'd like to thank Dr. Rajesh Prabhu, Dr. Kaushik Murli, and all the faculty at Shankara Eye Hospital for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.